learners, I'm Shivani Bali, teacher educator. Today we are going to learn specific aims of education at the elementary school stage. This topic is from course 504, block 1, unit 3. Before explaining the specific aims of elementary education, let me give you the brief history. In India, there is uniform education structure which we call 10 plus 2 plus 3 pattern. This pattern was adopted in post-independent India on recommendation of Education Commission. So based on the reports of Education Commission, Government of India first announced the National Policy of Education in 1968. As per this policy, all schools will provide compulsory education to children of age group 6 to 14 years. It's also there in the Article 21A of Indian Constitution that free and compulsory education would be provided to all children of age group 6 to 14 years, which form the basis of Right to Education Act. Now, formal education of these children of age group 6 to 14 years comes under the domain of elementary education. Now, let's see the structure of elementary education. Elementary education covers the children of 6 to 14 years of age group from class 1st to class 8th. It is further subdivided into two levels, primary and upper primary. Primary level covers the children of age group 6 to 10 years from class 1st to class 5th. And upper primary covers the children of age group 11 to 14 years from class 6th to class 8th. Now, what are the goals of mathematics education at elementary level? As per the guidelines of National Curriculum Framework 2005, which is one of the important framework of India, the main goal of mathematics education is to build abilities of mathematization in students. So by mathematization, we mean to bring mathematics in the thought process of a child to enable students to solve real and practical problems. Children should learn to think about any solution using the language of mathematics. Child should be able to make connections between mathematics and everyday mental activities. Students could appreciate the beauty of mathematics in nature and its application. There should be the development of cognitive domain, enhancement of problem-solving skills, critical thinking, analyzing, reasoning, and decision-making. So these were the goals of mathematics education. Now let's discuss the specific aims. So what are the specific aims of teaching mathematics? Specific aims of mathematics education are the instructional objectives of particular topic or lesson. Specific aims helps to first, design teaching learning materials and methods. Second, specific aims helps to design accuracy. It helps the student to develop accuracy in their mathematical activities. Number three, specific aims helps to develop interdisciplinary skills. Interdisciplinary skills. Interdisciplinary skills are like problem solving skills, critical analysis, reasoning, and many more. Next, specific aims helps to inculcate habits of patience, regularity, self-reliance, and much more. It gives clarity on fundamental concepts and processes. Fundamental concepts and processes. So these are the specific aims of teaching mathematics in education. For example, if we have to write the specific aim of teaching fractions, we'll write, after learning fractions, students will be able to identify numerator and denominator. Second, to distinguish different types of fractions like proper fraction, improper, equivalent, mixed fraction. Number three, to compare and order fractions. Number four, to convert improper fraction into mixed numbers, to add or subtract fractions with like and unlike denominators. Let's take another example where we have to find the specific aims of teaching area of rectangle. Students will be able to define perimeter of rectangle. Number two, recognize the difference between perimeter and area. Number three, to compute the area of square if the length is given. And next, to apply the concept on real life problems. Now we need to know how different are general aims from specific aims. General aims. These are the general aims of teaching mathematics. And whereas specific aims are content specific. Let's now find out other differences also. First, general aims are broad and indefinite, whereas specific aims are well definite and well defined. Second, general aims are subject specific, whereas specific aims are content specific. These are subject specific and specific aims are content or topic or lesson specific. General aims are immeasurable, whereas specific aims are measurable. They are immeasurable, whereas specific aims are measurable. Number four, general aims are difficult to evaluate, whereas specific aims are easy to evaluate. And specific aims are easy to evaluate. So these are the differences between general aim and specific aims. So now let's sum up what all we have learned. Elementary education consists of two levels, primary and upper primary. Second, the main goal of mathematics education at an elementary level is to mathematize children's thought process. Specific aims are instructional objectives of any topic or lesson. Specific aims of teaching mathematics is to develop disciplinary values, accuracy, design suitable methods, teaching learning materials and procedures. Specific aims are different from general aims. So this was all about specific aims of teaching mathematics. Dear learners, now let me give you a practice task. You can practice writing specific aims of teaching prime numbers or area of triangle. All you need to do is to write instructional objectives of teaching these concepts. So let's sum up what all we have learned. First, we learned about elementary education structure in India. Elementary education is divided into two parts. First is primary and other is upper primary. Primary education is for the children 6 to 10 years and upper primary is for the children 11 to 14 years. Elementary education is considered to be the most important level in the whole hierarchy of education. Number second, Then we learned about the goal of mathematics education. And the most important goal of mathematics education is to mathematize the thought process of child. So the child can apply what he has learned in the classroom and he can relate the classroom mathematics with the real life mathematics. Number third, then we learned about specific aims, which are the instructional objectives of any topic or lesson. Specific aims, which are called instructional objectives. Instructional objectives. Next, we did the features of specific aims. And the features of specific aims of teaching mathematics education is to develop interdisciplinary values like critical thinking, problem solving skills, reasoning skills, and to design teaching learning materials, methods, and procedures. Teaching, learning materials, which we call TLMs also, procedures and methods. Then we explain the difference between general aim and the specific aim. Now, general aim is different from specific aims. Specific aim, in terms that general aim is not definite, it's not clear, they are very broad and they are immeasurable and they are difficult to evaluate. So this was all about the specific aims of teaching mathematics. Now, dear learners, let me give you a practice task. You can practice writing specific aims of teaching prime numbers or area of triangle or any other topic of your choice. All you need to do is to write instructional objectives of teaching these concepts. In the words of great mathematician William Paul Thurston, mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It's about understanding. So let's develop the understanding among our students with this powerful tool called teaching. Here I conclude my session. Thank you.